Hello everyone. Today we will talk about how to design a URL shortener. So let's get started. Let's talk about functional requirements and non-functional requirements. Given an original URL and optional custom short key, our service should be able to generate a short and unique URL of it. When user tries to access a short URL, our service should be able to redirect them to original URL. Also, all short URL will expire after the standard default time span from the key generation. This service should be having very low latency in terms of non-functional requirements, also should be highly available. There is one more important key point here. All short URLs which are being generated should be random, unpredictable, and non-guessable by the user. Okay. So now let's talk about a very basic system design, how we can build this service quickly. Assuming every user is trying to feed a long URL into the system with the expectation that we will generate a short URL out of it and we will give it to the user and they can share the same short URL with their friends. Now, when their friends try to click on that short URL, our service will redirect them to long URL. Okay. Now, assuming all logged in users can have the flexibility of giving a custom short key of length 3 to 10, while non-logged in users will not have that flexibility and we will start generating automatically a random short key of length 7 to them. Okay. Now, we can have a URL shortener plus redirection service, which can have some encoding mechanism in it and can generate a short key of length 7 out of it. Why we are choosing length 7? Because considering base 62 encoding, number of short keys with length 7 can be generated around 3.5 trillion over the lifetime, which is quite enough for this system. Okay. Now, for every long URL, since we are generating a short URL, to make it easy to read or to make it easy to redirect, we should have a mapping in our NoSQL DB, use short key DB, where key is the short key and value will be long URL created at an expiry time. Okay. This is a very basic system design. Whenever we feel like a particular URL is being a hot read, I mean, is being clicked very frequently, okay, we can have a LRU, least recently used sort of cache eviction policy, and we can store those most popular 20% short URLs in our hot short URLs global cache for the redirection purpose, easy to fetch. Okay. Now, there can be a scenario where a URL shortener service may end up in a situation while transforming or while generating a short key from URL, the same key, it may generate the same key and the service needs to regenerate the key again and again by adding some different salt or some other parameters into it, right? So we might end up in a situation where generated key already exists, but that should not be the case. Okay. We should avoid hash collision. Okay. But how we can avoid hash collision better? Can short key generation be quite independent of long URL itself? Yes, it can. We can have a key generation service which can generate all unused keys DB offline and have these pre-computed and save it into the DB. And URL shortener service can always ask for fresh key from key generation service. Now, how to ensure the same key doesn't get allotted to other server? Okay. Because this URL shortener and redirection service might have multiple servers, okay? And we want to make sure there's no inconsistency in the key allotment. How this can be done by making sure this key generation service has two tables, one for unused keys and other for all used keys or all keys which has been allotted so far to the different servers of URL shortness service. Okay. Now, can we load bulk short keys in lot on each server periodically? Because now if you look at the scenario, URL shortness service is asking for a fresh key every time the user feeds the long URL. Okay. And this might create a huge load on key generation service as well. Okay. Can we reduce the load and can we make it a little faster for URL shortness service to not do the network call and do it very quickly on the service level itself? Yes, we can. How we can do this? The key generation service can start acting as a lot allotter service as well, where rather than serving an individual key every time, this service can allot, or this service can provide a bunch of keys, a complete lot of keys to a particular server. Okay, and can maintain what all keys has been allotted in the DB as well. Okay, and now this URL shortener service will start loading all these bunch of keys into the local cache. So for example, whenever a URL shortener server finds that its key lot local cache needs to be refilled, it will quickly call KGLA service to ask for a next lot of keys. One lot means 1 lakh keys, let's say. Okay. And KGLA service will move those 1 lakh keys from unused DB and move it to used key table. Okay. And will also mark them all these keys allotted to that particular server ID. Now, KGLA service will send those 1 lakh keys to requesting server, and this particular server can load it to its key lot local cache. Okay, quite simple. Now, how can KGLA service check faster if generated key definitely does not exist in unused plus used key DB? Because what is happening currently, every time KGLA service is generating of key offline, okay, and putting it into unused DB, it has to check in the DB whether this key exists or not, which is a big O of N operation. Okay, we want to make it faster. We can do it faster by using a Bloom filter. What is Bloom filter? Bloom filter is primarily a probabilistic data structure which allows us to check very quickly if this particular item definitely does not exist in the DB. And this can be done without checking in the DB itself. And while actual operation to check key in the DB will take big O of N, while using Bloom filter, it would be a big O of K only, where K is the total number of hash functions we are applying on the particular item. Okay, we will not go in depth for Bloom filter for now, but we'll give a very quick idea how Bloom filter works. So now we are having Bloom filter. We want to have 100% guarantee if this key definitely does not exist. Okay, we will just generate it and save it. If it might be present, okay, there is a 99.99% chance this is present, and 0.01% chance this might not be present, but we do not want to do a database label call again, and probably for those 0.01% of cases, or for every cases where Bloom filter says this item might be present, we might want to regenerate key very quickly rather just check. Okay. So this will save a hell lot of time. Now, how can URL shortener service also check faster if custom short key being provided by the user, logged in user, definitely does not exist? Okay, the same thing. We can use a Bloom filter for used short keys also. So for example, a custom key comes, we will quickly check in the prune filter. If this key definitely does not exist, if yes, we will mark it as used and we will map it to the long URL. If it might be there, we will probably say user, hey, this key present is already present, please give a some different custom key. So what we are trying to do here, basically a bloom filter which is having a 0.0001% of false positive probability, and obviously 0% of false negative probability, would require just around 24 MB space to do a membership test if this particular key exists, okay, on 10 million keys using just 10 hash functions. This is something which we can calculate from a Bloom filter calculator as well. Now, Bloom filter will allow us to have big O of M space complexity and big O of K time complexity, where M is the total number of bits in the Bloom filter and K is the total number of hash functions being used. Since mostly the number of hash functions K is very less than N or close to log base to N, we can guarantee that this is much faster than actually checking this particular key exists in DB or not, right? So Bloom filter helps us to optimize on time complexity and it doesn't take much space altogether. Now, if a custom key is being used, how we can inform that KGL service should not allot this key to any other server? This can be done by publishing an event from URL shorten saying, hey, a new custom key has been been in used, okay, and please mark it as used and do not allot it to any other server. Can we also collect expired short URL keys for use? Yes, this can be done by having a expired keys collector service which will start collecting all used short keys periodically into unused keys table. Okay. Now, if we talk about offline key generation algorithm, it is quite simple. Check periodically if unused plus used keys DB need to be refilled. Okay. If yes, repeat the following until refill count is achieved. Number one, generate random 7-letter alphanumeric key. Check if this key is definitely does not exist in unused plus used key Bloom filter cache first. If yes, then we can directly go and save it in the DB and update the Bloom filter cache quickly. If not, we can say we need to repeat the same process for generating the key again. Now, let's talk about URL shortening algorithm. Let's say if no custom short key has been provided by the user, we can quickly remove one key from key lot local cache, and this key would be definitely not present in the used short keys because this was provided by KGLA service altogether. Okay, that means it doesn't exist in DB. We need not to check at all. We can directly go to step C. But in case custom key is being provided, we need to check in Bloom filter cache if this key definitely not exist. Okay. If does not exist, we can quickly update the mapping in the DB and Bloom filter cache and publish the event for KGLA service to mark this particular custom key being used in the unused plus used keys DB and its Bloom filter cache. Okay. And if this key exists, we can throw exception to the user, hey, this custom key already exists, please provide a new key. Okay. So far we have created a distributed URL shortener. Hope you like this video. Please like, share, and subscribe this video. Thank you.